Hello, it is Friday, January 28th, 2022, and this is Consistency Over Intensity. Please do not waste your time watching this video unless you have a very specific reason to watch this video. What is the consistency over intensity thing? It's kind of a workout, and the workout is a not very intense workout of about 27 different exercises, but done consistently, meaning almost every day. Didn't do it yesterday, but I've been getting a whole bunch of stuff done this week, so there's been moving in the right direction in a lot of ways. Okay, so let's see here. Let's double check a couple things. All right, I got a little bit of time, so that's good. Yeah. All right. So consistency of this workout answers on the way towards answering two questions. Question one is consistency better than intensity in the long run? Hopefully this will prove that if I keep consistently doing this workout. And the second question is about breath and doing four phases of breath, because I'm doing lightweight and small sets. If I have minimal breaks in between, then that means I'm working harder, I think. There is a breath cycle that I'm working towards. Since I'm using small sets, I'm going to use this breath cycle. And, the cycle is four parts of breath equaling four repetitions. The first repetition of an exercise, I am breathing out. The second repetition, I am holding empty. Third repetition, I am breathing in. And the fourth repetition, usually the last in most exercises, is holding full. And that is a full cycle of breath, which is also one set according to this thing I'm trying to play around with, this idea, this concept. And hopefully it'll do good things. So we shall see about that. What was I about to ask myself on video? No, nothing. No, it's really... Let's get started with it. Oh, the protocol, not the protocol, the sequence. Stretching first, then the first exercise, which is a wrist exercise, then stretching, wrist exercise, then warm-up set, then the rest of the exercises. So 26 other exercises. Okay, and 7 different dynamic stretches. So here we go. And those will be using the same breath protocol. So here we go. Yay. Trying to get excited about this. good day to do this. That's probably a good spot, a good way to put that. Gotta get the breath right. Feels about right.
breath pattern is going to be a little bit different for these. I'm going to do two or maybe three cycles of breath for each cycle. Well, at least for the first two cycles, I'm going to do two repetitions. Well, every cycle, two repetition per phase of breath. The third cycle, I'm only going to do two phases of breath, the inhale or the exhale and the inhale. So it's going to be exhale. Well, first I'm going to do a plank for about one cycle of breath, not very long. And then I'm going to do push-ups, and it'll be two push-ups on the exhale, two push-ups on the hold empty, two push-ups on the inhale, two push-ups on the hold full for two cycles of breath. And then that third cycle, I'm just going to breathe out the exhale, do two push-ups, breathe in, do the inhale, two push-ups, and then be done. Get some nice round numbers, and also get to play with a variation in the breath. So that's kind of fun too. Wow, that felt way more intense than it should have. Interesting. Guess you're gonna have your weekdays too. Weekdays. Weekdays on weekdays. Gotta go charge something up real quick. I'm not even sure if my breath pattern was right on that one. I hope it was. Deal. Good stuff. Well, focusing on good stuff. Actually, being able to help out somebody that I didn't think I'd be able to help out. I had no idea that I was in the queue to help out till last week. And honestly, I wasn't looking forward to the effort to help out. But it seems like the major portions are on the easier side now. It seems like the major portions of the hurdles have been jumped. So that's good. Very happy about that. Oh man, good stuff. Oh. Oh. So yeah, glad to help. It seems to be like a slogan of my life in a lot of ways. And then there's some part of like the 5-year-old me about I got a lot of things I want. Life ain't perfect. And there's probably a couple things missing, but nothing I can handle. And nothing I'm not in some ways better without. So cool. Like my friend would say, cool story, bro. Yeah. Some words I don't say because most reasonable-minded folks consider I'm lying. I'm not, but I don't want to be putting that up for consideration. Like, do I look like I've been working out fairly consistently for the last, let's say, 4 years? Maybe less than four, I don't know. 3 years, let's say. No, not really. Not where I want to be. But then again, that statement is reasonably, regularly, and working out, not intensely working out, you know. Also, until there's been incremental, small changes in my diet, which is getting tighter and tighter. Although I've made a couple mistakes. And last night, one of those was pizza. There was pizza. I don't know if I want to just slow down pizza or stop it. There's part of me that's just like, dude, just stop it. Zero's easy. Until it's not, but. Now, there's one point in my life, it would be sacrilegious to say, give up on pizza? Pizza would never give up on you. And that's the problem. Yeah. Eventually, I do want this to go away. I actually went ahead and watched part of one of my videos from, like, years ago. One of the first ones. I also watched one of the first band videos I had many years ago. And, only 3 years ago, but still. Different. Same person. Slightly different states of mind. I think I've actually matured a little bit since then. A bit more careful with my emotions and words. A bit more considerate, hopefully. A bit more tools in the toolbox. Like, a friend of mine was talking about emotions and impulsivity. And, I basically said, I gave up on trying to control my emotions. I'm just not very good at it. But, I've gotten really a lot better at controlling my reactions to my own emotions. I let the emotions do whatever they want. I'll listen. Do what you're ever going to do. But that's all internal. I'll let you run crazy internal. That's your playground. External is my reaction to the emotion. And my thoughts in regard to the emotion, too. And it's a weird separation. Once I started thinking it in that perspective, things changed. Once I saw my emotions as not something to be broken down or destroyed or beaten or gotten around, I just saw them as something like, and some people would hate this phrase, but something that's allowed to process. And maybe sometimes doing a few things to help the process, but, you know, the most important part is not trying to control it. Let it do its thing inside of me. Let it express itself. Let that emotion exist. Not try to justify its existence one way or the other. Just know that it's there and it's in relation to something. Okay, it's there. I can see that. What's my reaction to that? And that's the tool that seems, for the most part, to work for me. But at the same time, I know that there's other tools out there. And maybe there's better tools out there for me. But this one may not be optimal, but it works in a lot of ways. I can't really think of too many of the drawbacks, except for the biggest drawback is I have to let go of the idea of controlling my emotions, because that seems like just such a powerful, wonderful thing. In control of your emotions. Wow, that's intense. Give up on that goal, that idea. Yeah, that was something, a substantial mark of my own character, you know, admitting to your own weaknesses. But controlling my reactions to it, so much easier. It's the difference between building a log cabin by hand and building a log cabin with tools and building a log cabin with, you know, power tools. There's various phases in there. And it's like, as soon as you wake up and realize, hey, I can use tools, you know, to build this. And then the next thing is, hey, cool, I know how the tools work. Oh, I can use these power tools. That done even more efficiently. Be a lot less sore. I wonder if anybody has ever actually built a log cabin without any tools whatsoever. I'm talking not even like rocks, that like sharp rocks that they break apart and, you know, like literally punching the tree. I don't know. I mean, it's a big world out there, and there might be somebody who has. It might not look like much of a log cabin. It might be some tiny logs in that cabin. It might be closer to a basket than it is a cabin, but it was done 100% by hand. No tools whatsoever. No cutting tools, no sharp rocks, nothing. So it probably exists, but maybe it's a very loose definition of what the word cabin is. Fire pit, not fireplace. Well, that's about enough of that. Sitting thinking. Gonna go to a show. Later it shall be.